Define scintillation and explain scintillation counter. And now you can also get my lecture notes from chepekmedia.co.nf. When the radioactive radiations are incident on phosphor, they produce flash of light. This phenomena is known as scintillation. Zinc sulfide and barium platinum cyanide are phosphors for alpha rays. The scintillation can be measured in terms of pulse of current with the help of photomultiplier tube and electrometer. In 1947, H. Kallman devised the scintillation counter. It is consist of following three components. First is phosphor. It may be organic or inorganic compound. Organic solid phosphors are naphthalene, anthracene, stilbene, etc. And organic liquid phosphors are terphenyl in toluene or terphenyl in xylene. Inorganic solid phosphors are sodium iodide crystals activated with 0.5 mole thallium. As the sodium iodide is hygroscopic, it must be kept in airtight metal box and front side is made up of thin aluminum film. When ionizing radiations like alpha and beta particles are incident on it, it produces scintillation, that is flash of light. This light is scattered in all the possible directions. As the light is proportional to the number of alpha or beta particles incident, so the light is very important. It may strike with the walls of the container and may be wasted. To avoid this, the interior part of the metallic box is coated with light reflectors. So all the light which is produced due to scintillation phenomena is allowed to incident on photocathode of PMT. PMT is photomultiplier tube. It works on the phenomena of secondary emission. It is long metallic tube. A sensitive photoanode is placed at one end of the tube and series of electrodes called dianodes are arranged in the tube. The surface of photocathode is coated with cesium and antimony alloy. The dianodes are connected in such a way that each dianode is at a more positive potential than previous one. Thus, the electron beam traveling from one dianode to the other is continuously accelerated. When light strikes a dianode, the electrons are ejected out from the surface of the photocathode due to photoelectric effect and gets attracted towards next dianode, where they can eject even more electrons. Each incident electron on the surface of dianode is capable to eject the four electrons. Thus, the electrons go on multiplying. Finally, all these accelerated and multiplied electrons are incident on photoanode, which is fixed at the other end of the photomultiplier tube. And the last part is electrometer. The photoanode of PMT is connected with electrometer, which gives the current. From the magnitude of the current, we can find out amount of radiations which have entered the metallic box in the given time interval. Advantages: the scintillation counter can be used for the measurement of alpha, beta and gamma rays. Only we have to change the phosphor. Second, the amplification is very high, is about 10 to the power 6 to 10 to the power 8. Limitations: large number of radiations are wasted as the source is kept outside the metal box. The instrument is costly.